We're in the town of Wardak, west of Kabul. We had planned to fly out to the Afghan-Pakistan border today, but the low ceiling and the snow prevented that flight. We drove out here, and there's a compelling security situation in this town. The local governor says that the situation changed dramatically within the past year. He says the stores here and the fruit stands now stay open late into the night. They did close just a year ago because of security concerns about the Taliban. In this town, they're using local police, Afghan local police, a program that's empowering their own security. It's something that commanders are touting down in the Helmand and Kandahar province in the south as well, a bottom-up security plan.
See it.
I talked to General David Petraeus about this, the role of Pakistan, the role of attacks that are constant, even almost 10 years after this war started.
Afghan and ISAF forces have halted the Taliban momentum in most of the country and reversed it in some very important areas, but recognize that that's not true of the whole country, and that indeed there will be a Taliban spring offensive, and there will also be an Afghan and ISAF spring offensive.
So in the south, in Helmand and Kandahar, that's the biggest success story right now?
It's an area of progress. I'm loath to use terms like success or even winning or victory or anything like that. These are areas in which our forces with Afghan partners, by the way, in some areas the Afghan partners now outnumbering ISAF forces, have achieved through very tough fighting significant progress.
But the Taliban wants that back.
Certainly they do. And they will come back and they will try to re-infiltrate. They will carry out sensational attacks to, if you, in a sense, discredit the progress. They'll do whatever they can do. And of course, Afghan and ISAF forces and Afghan officials will do all that we can to prevent that from happening.
What role do you think Pakistan plays in all this?
Well, Pakistan, of course, is a sanctuary for leaders of the Taliban, leaders and elements of the Haqqani network, and some others. They have made considerable progress in their fight and their counterinsurgency effort against the Tariqi Taliban Pakistani and the other elements that were threatening the very existence of Pakistan as they knew it some 2 years or so ago. As they push some of their Taliban towards the Durand Line, the border, in the very rugged areas between Afghanistan and Pakistan, we will be the anvil against which their hammer strikes, as we have done in the past. And there are plans for more of that over time.
I mean, there's big camps on the Pakistan side that seem to be funneling people into Afghanistan, down by Quetta and then Mirim Shah. There's another one on the other side of the border that everybody seems to know about, everybody seems to talk about it, but yet they just kind of are there.
There's actually a great deal more friction in the gears of the Taliban than we think has been present in the past. There's certainly far more pressure on them than they have ever experienced.
But if we'd use drone attacks inside Pakistan, why couldn't we take out these camps on the other side that are funneling all these people into Afghanistan?
Well, that's a good question for the policymakers, the Central Command commander.
You're the guy here.
And any others. We're focused on our effort inside Afghanistan, obviously.